Hello all, good morning. And in the last classes, we have seen the derivation of how a power system network is being analyzed and what are the different methods for the further analysis of that power system. And we know that to optimally analyze the power system, we have to minimize the cost that is used for the operation of your power system. So for the minimal operation of the power, cost analysis of the power system, first we need to analyze that power system. So that analysis of the power system is done using four methods. One is Newton-Raphson method, Gauss-Seidel method, fast decoupled and decoupled methods. So decoupled and fast decoupled methods. So the four methods. So these four methods to understand, we should know the primitive admittance matrix, primitive admittance form of the matrix and primitive impedance form of the matrix. So primitive admittance form and primitive impedance form we have to know, and we have to know how to derive the equation for the Y-bus. Y-bus is nothing but primitive admittance form. So Y-bus, primitive admittance form, or Y-bus is the bus admittance matrix. So to analyze this bus admittance matrix, we know that we are having two methods. One is singular transformation method, which we have already seen in the last class. Singular transformation method. The formula for the Y bus is bus admittance matrix, and the formula for this we have derived in the last class as A transpose into Y into A. So it is your formula. This is nothing but bus admittance matrix. Bus admittance matrix. And A and A transpose are nothing but bus incidence matrix. Bus incidence matrix. And Y is admittance primitive form, or primitive admittance matrix. Primitive admittance matrix. So using this formula, we can easily derive for any kind of network, either it may be larger network or it may be smaller network. So for any kind of network, we can easily form the bus admittance matrix using A transpose into Y into A. This is your singular transformation method, which we have seen in the last class. Now, moving on to the other type of derivation. Derivation of Y-bus using another method called direct inspection method. Direct inspection method. Derivation of Y-bus using direct inspection method. So this is one method and this is your other method. So in this method, let us now consider an electrical network which is having admittances like this, which is connected. It is in a pie-shaped network. Let us consider a pie-shaped network. A pie-shaped network which is being energized by I1, current source I1, and here another current source I2. Okay, and let this be your Y2, and let this be your Y1, and let this be your Y3. The voltage at this point, let it be V1, and voltage at this node, let it be V2, and let it be in the connected to the ground or reference node like this. Okay, this is your first node, and this is your second node. Let this be your first node and second node. Okay, now applying case, how to derive Y-bus from this is, now let us see. Okay, first apply KCL at first node, at node 1. So what is KCL? KCL is nothing but the Kirchhoff's current law, which is nothing but the sum at a node, at a meeting point of all the power system elements. So at that point, the sum of incoming currents is equal to the sum of outgoing currents. So what are the sum of incoming currents? What are the currents that are being income coming in into the node 1 is equal to the sum of currents which are outgoing at the node 2. So what is the incoming current? Incoming current is I1, which is equals to V1 minus 0 into Y1 plus voltage drop across V1, and this is your 0. So the voltage drop across your second reference node is 0. So I have taken it V1 minus 0 into Y1 plus V1 minus V2 into Y2. Let us simplify this one. I1 is equals to V1 Y1 plus V2 Y2, which is equals to V1 into Y1 plus Y2 minus V2 Y2, which is equals to I1. Let this be your equation number 1. Now, again, apply the same concept at the node 2. Applying KCL at node 2. So whenever you are applying KCL at the second node, now at this second node also incoming current should be equal to your outgoing current. So what are the incoming currents? Only I2 is incoming. So I2 is equals to voltage drop across this admittance Y2 and voltage drops across the admittance Y3. So it is equals to, first take this Y3. So it is V2 minus 0 into Y3 plus, what is this one? V2 minus V1 into Y2. So I2 is equals to V2 Y3 plus, I am just simplifying it, V2 into Y2 plus, sorry, minus V1 into Y2. So I2 is equal to minus V1 into Y2 plus V2 into Y2 plus Y3. Let this be your equation number 2. So we are having only two currents, two nodes, and we have taken the concept of three admittances, and we have derived the equations for 1 and 2. Two equations we have derived. Now let us write these two equations in the form of a matrix. So in the form of matrix, if we are representing, it is I1 I2 into, let this, keep it as like this, then here we are having V1 and V2 in both the equations. Here also we are having V1 and V2, and here also we are having V1 and V2. Now let this be your A11 element, let this A21 element, let this be your A21 element, and let this be your A22 element. So your A11 element, nothing but I1 for the first equation. For I1 and V1, what is your concept, what is your elements that are present for I1 and V1? So it is I1 and V1, it is Y1 plus Y2. And I1 and V2 elements, what is it, is I1 and V2 elements, it is equals to minus Y2. Similarly, from the second equation, I2, which is equals to I2 and V1 combination is minus Y2. I2 and V1 combination is minus Y2. And here it is the I2 and V2 combination is Y3 plus Y2. So from this is your final admittance matrix. So this concept, this is your final admittance matrix. So here it is, I bus is equals to Y bus into V bus. So what is your Y bus? Y bus is, I'll write it here, Y bus is equals to, it is nothing but Y1 plus Y2, and it is minus Y2, and here it is minus Y2, and it is Y2 plus Y3. So in general sense, we can say it as, in general sense we can say it as the diagonal elements. Diagonal elements, nothing but Y11, Y22, Y33. If you are having three buses, then it is Y33. If you are having four buses, you will get Y44. So the diagonal elements can be obtained by adding the all the admittances that are connected to that node. See, if you are taking Y11 is first node. So whatever the elements that are connected to the first node, what are the elements that are connected? Y1 and Y2. So your Y11 is Y1 plus Y2. And second node, Y22 is your second node. So it is second node. What are the elements that are connected to second node? We can see it as Y2 plus Y3. So second node is Y2 plus Y3. So sum of all admittances connected to nodes. Connected to that node. And off diagonal elements can be obtained, nothing but Y12, Y21, that's it, first two buses. If it is third bus, Y23 and Y32, like that. If there are three number of nodes are present, then three buses are present, then it is like this. So these elements can be obtained by negative of the admittance value. Negative of the admittance value between A and B nodes. If it is YAB, then it can be obtained by negative of the admittance value between A and B. Negative of the admittance value between A and B. I'll cross check it. See, I want the value for Y12. So to get the value for the Y12, so it is between first node and second node. What is the admittance that has connected between first node and second node? It is nothing but Y2. So it is equals to minus negative sign of minus Y2. So it is negative sign of minus Y2. If you want to check it for the Y21, if you want to check it out. So Y21 is nothing but between second and first node, whatever the admittance value that is connected. So what is the admittance value connected between second node and first node? Negative of Y2. So in this method, diagonal elements can be obtained by summing up all the admittances that are connected to that node. And and off diagonal elements, that means Y12, Y21, Y23, Y32, Y34, Y43. So these off diagonal elements can be obtained by taking the negative of the admittance that is connected between A and B node, whatever the admittance that is being connected, that is the off diagonal element value. So this method is very, very, very easy when compared to your singular transformation method. So because singular transformation method, we have to take the value for admittance. We have first take the value for bus incidence matrix A. We have to get the matrix for the bus incidence matrix. And again, we have to take the transpose of that. And we have to multiply all these. So it is a bit difficult. But whenever you are having a mutual admittance, that means, see, between these two values also, this is one bus which is having an admittance value of Y1, and this is your second bus which is having an admittance value of Y2, and this is your third bus which is having an admittance value of Y3. So between these three buses, between this bus to this bus, if there is an admittance value of Y4, then this method, we can't use the direct inspection method. Direct inspection method will not be valid if there is a mutual admittance in the network. Generally, for ideal networks, there will not be any mutual admittance. Mutual admittance is nothing but some amount of leakage admittance may be present in your network. So whenever that amount of leakage admittance is present in your network, your this method will not be valid. What is the method that is valid whenever you are having some mutual admittance is using singular transformation method. So until and unless if you are having a mutual admittance between the buses, if the question is given as between the buses, if you are having any kind of mutual admittances, then go for singular transformation method. Or else you can directly take the derivation of the y bus using this direct inscription method, which is very simpler. If you just know the diagram, the off diagonal elements are taken by the negative of the admittance between your two nodes, and if the diagonal elements can be taken by the adding up all the admittances that are connected to the particular node. So this is very easy direct inspection method only if there is no mutual admittance between two buses. If there is a mutual admittance, you have to go for the singular transformation method. So thank you.